All right, so let's take a look at what options and features are available for us to help us distribute our presentation. So if you recall from our scenario, we are going to distribute the presentation via CD. And in doing so, it's going to assemble we want to assemble all the files that we need. We want to optimize our space usage and make sure everything's available. So one of the things I'd like to point out to you is that you have the opportunity to manually optimize your space usage by selecting an item such as a photo. And if I knew that this particular photo was a very large one, maybe one of these 4 megabyte photos, I could select it. I could go to Format Ribbon for Picture Tools, and then I would select Compress Pictures, and I can choose a resolution that's of lower quality than what I actually had it at in order to save a significant amount of space. So in this case, that's done individually, but let's say I wanted to do it as a whole for the entire presentation. I've got various assets in there that might need to be reduced. You'll notice under the Info pane of the backstage that we have the size of the media that's embedded. 43 megabytes is pretty large. We have a notation that one of our media files contains trimmed regions. So that means that there's video that would never be displayed, so it really doesn't need to be in the presentation. So if we hit our compressed media option, we can select a different quality, and it'll process all the files within. We don't have time for the whole thing, so I'm going to cancel out of that. And then you will save a significant amount of space for when you ultimately want to package it. So now let's look at packaging. If we go to the Export pane and we select Package Presentation for CD, we can then prepare our presentation for the CD, and we can either burn it directly to the CD or put it into a subdirectory within on our hard drive. Let's take a look at the options. Let's say we wanted to protect it. We want to put a password on it. You have the opportunity to do that here. We'll revisit protecting presentations later on in the next scenario that we talk about. It should be noted also that in preparing this, it's going to assemble all the files that are associated with the presentation into a common location. So that requires it to copy files to your machine. So you might see a warning about that, depending upon whether or not you've linked to external files. So for now, we'll cancel out of that. And let's go ahead. I don't have a CD available, so I'm going to go ahead and copy this all to a folder. I'll use the defaults. And here's our warning about linked files within it. Do we want to include these linked files in our package? Yes, we do. And there are some annotations and comments within ours that are not going to get copied along, and that's fine. And automatically popped up the directory in which everything got copied to. We have our presentation, and we have supporting files for it. Everything that we need. So you don't have to be as worried about assembling everything and taking care of that all yourself as a manual process. So with that said, I'm going to give you an opportunity to try another export method right now.